Let's go! It's football season, everybody! I need the hype music! You know, a lot of people around here are down on Chris Ash, but not me. I consider myself an asshole. 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 And on Friday, we're gonna pack the Shy full of assholes. We got McLean Carter, McLean Starter, the Fire Starter, the Red Rifle, the Southpaw. I wrote this assuming the starter would be announced by now. We got Art Sitkowski, Start Sitkowski, Kelly Kapowski. That's only there because Mike insisted that I make a Saved by the Bell reference. We got Isaiah Pacheco. 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 That's not just his name. That's the sound of him bouncing off tacklers. Pacheco. Pacheco. We got Raheem Blackshear, beloved by Reggie Bush, who somehow is the only person to have been kicked out of a club that includes O.J. Simpson. We got Aaron Young. I thought he was the pie man, but it's actually Isaiah Washington. We got Davon Robinson, probably the best receiver on the roster, who for some reason was a tight end last year. We've got a bunch of other receivers, and we have no idea which of them are going to play. We got Tyshawn Fogg, the Fog Machine. He probably deserves a better nickname. We got Willington Prevalon. Sounds like the name of a British butler. We got CJ Onyechi donating $50 to Aid for Africa for each sack this season. He's going to be broke by the end of the season. More so, pay the players. We got Trey Avery, the touchdown savory, because he saves touchdowns. We got Adam Corsack, the Aussie assassin, the assassin. But of course, we're not punting a single time this season, so we better get used to the bench. We got Cole Murphy, Hold Murphy, the best holder in all the land. Preseason Holder of the Year watch list. Yes, that is the thing that exists. And look at this cupcake schedule that we have. I don't see a single loss, do you? It starts with UMass. UMass? You ass. Iowa, this is not your year to start a completely fraudulent 8-0 when everyone knows you're not any good. Kirk Ferentz, future NFL head coach for the last 30 years. It ain't gonna happen, bro. Boston College, some are calling it the biggest game of the Chris Ash era. Yeah, it's going to be the biggest something, the biggest blowout. Michigan, hey Harbaugh, we're going to make you soil your stupid khakis that are apparently from Lululemon. Hey Lululemon, if you're listening, we'd love to become the official podcast of Lululemon in exchange for briefcases of cash. Their clothes are so expensive. Maryland, it doesn't matter what happens, you will always be the school that hired Randy Edsall. By the way, Rutgers fans, we can always say, hey, at least we're not UConn. Indiana, according to Kevin Fine, one of the original listeners of this podcast, Indiana is a state so bad that if you live there, you sometimes have to eat at Subway in order to survive. We ain't losing to them. Minnesota, PJ Fleck, PJ Fleck, row the boat, row the boat. You're going to row the boat right over a waterfall and into a river of shit at our newly named stadium. Also, everyone knows that row the boat is just chop the wood with a different verb and noun. You're a thief, Fleck. Illinois, why does Lovie Smith have the beard of Tom Hanks in Castaway? Have you seen this? Google it. Next is Ohio State. Blow Ohio State. And when we're done with you, you're going to be no Mohio State. Michigan State would have the most awful scandal in college sports history if not for the next team on the schedule. Penn State, Penn's taint, Crappy Valley, James Franklin, Lames Franklin. Now you may notice I left one team off the schedule. I have the right to discriminate against any university that I may feel like, and I randomly chose to discriminate against this one. I don't care what the critics say. The night is always darkest before the dawn. Harvey Dent said that in The Dark Knight. And before that, it was said by English theologian Thomas Fuller in a religious travelogue he wrote back in 1650. Guys, it's the 150th anniversary of college football, and we're going to celebrate it with our second national championship. Remember, we were co-champions back in 1869. Are you guys excited? It's finally here. It's football season. This is our time. We are Rutgers football. And there's just one more thing, boys. Say it with me. We are Scarlet Knights, the most passionate fans in college athletics.
We cheer our teams, win or lose.
We stand when our teams exit and enter the field of play.
We welcome our opponents and their fans as guests in our university home.
We respect all student athletes and celebrate their efforts.
We know our enthusiasm on game day helps to recruit the nation's best.
We strive to make everybody's experience enjoyable.
We are the State University and Big Ten proud.
This is Rutgers.
R-U-U. Woo! 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 Yeah!